disadvantage also is there. So whenever we think of the situation in India, and it bothers people, understand that all the vyavasthas were created to aid, and they did also. But then when those very vyavasthas are not reformed, then the vyavastha itself becomes a structure that binds you, structure that restrains you. Ultimately, people will revolt. If you don't give them freedom, then they will break through. That's what will happen. So we are not giving, when the reformers come along and they reform the society well and good, otherwise society revolts, you know, and people then give up things. They stop following certain customs, nothing manta, nothing karta. They don't do it simply, that's all. It's just too bothering, you know, and too restrictive and too embarrassing and stuff like that, you know. So it's all right for people to be embarrassed because they thought that it was their place to be embarrassed. They don't want to be embarrassed anymore, and so they give up certain things, and that's all. So this is how certain things are just given up. People get fed up with the things, or they don't see any meaning in that. Either you reform, either you explain people why those things are there and how the very same spirit can be maintained today also. But then, when the structure becomes restraining, the spirit also is thrown away along with the structure. This is how it happens everywhere. Anyway. Okay, so where are we here? So Amum Yaja, that is where the whole business started. Worship this Devata, worship that Devata. Which was fine. Because everybody cannot worship every Devata, you know. Somehow I like Lord Shiva, that's all. What else can I do? Bhartuvari, such a great person, says, I know that all the Devatas are one. Still my heart only goes to Lord Shiva, you know. That's all he says. And all the Devatas are one, even though Tulsidas will say, still my heart goes to Rama, you know. And so, even though, so these are all stories, that when he sees Lord Krishna, he wants to see it only as Rama. So, the heart has a thing, but if the head is in its own place, then that need not create a problem. That just as my heart is devoted to a given deity, somebody else's heart may be devoted to some other deity, which is perfectly legitimate or alright. There's no need that the devotion must be necessarily to one. But then, we cannot have that kind of generosity because of insecurity. So anyway, amum yaja, worship this devata, worship that devata, for this result and that result. Iti ekaikam devam, that they accept these devatas are all different from other devata. Each devata is different from the other. That is wrong because etasya vasa visrishtihi. In fact, etasya prajapateh, of this prajapati alone, this is whole projection of creation, eshau eva sarve devaha. He indeed is all the devatas. So this is the looked upon as the ninda of the duality, you know. And the purpose is not ninda, but purpose is actually to extol the oneness. To extol the oneness, sometimes there is a criticism of the opposite view. That's the style. That is called arthavada. So going to page 176. Tadyat idam ityadi vakyasya tatparyam athaidi. First of all, Vaishyakara gives us tatparya. Or why Shruti has to say amum yaja, and then tanna, that is not so. So what is the tatparya there? It says Vaishyakara. Atha evam prakaranarthe vyavasthite tastutyabhiprayena avidvan matantara ninda nindo upanyasah anya ninda anya stutaye. Atha, thereafter, evam prakaranase vyavasthite. When the prakaranase is what? Srashta prajapati eva srushtam sarvam karyam iti prakaranase purokta prakarana vyavasthite sati. So in the manner in which it has been stated so far, that prajapati eva srushtam sarvam karyam, that srashta prajapati, the creator prajapati indeed is this whole creation. Iti prakaranarthe purvokta prakarana vyavasthite sati. When the prakaranartha, so that is the intention here, or that is what is thought to be conveyed by this passage, when it has been so established, firmly established now, anandram. So sati anandram vanna should be added there. Sati anandram tasyeva stuti vivakshaya. Now the Shruti wants to do the stuti of the fact that Prajapati is a creator and the whole creation is nothing but Prajapati. That's that unity or oneness of Prajapati is desired to be praised by the Shruti. In order to create that value, why again should it be praised? In order to create a value of that oneness in the mind of the seeker, so that in his life also he will pursue oneness. In order to encourage the student to meditate upon the oneness of Prajapati, it is necessary to extol that oneness, and to extol that oneness, there is apparently here a ninda or criticism of the duality, the perception of duality. Tasseva Shruti Vivakshaya. Tasseva Prakrana Tasseva Shruti Vivakshaya. Tadyat idam ityadi avidvan matantrasya nindatham vachanam ityardha. Avidvan mat. Avidvan means ignorant. So, opinion of the ignorant who believe that all devatas are different, that opinion is here criticized in order to extol the oneness which is stated here. That's the idea. So, Vashyaka Asayavam Prakaranarte Vyavasthite Tastuti Abhiprayana, meaning Prakaranartha Stuti Abhiprayana. What is Prakaranartha? That Prajapati is the creator and the whole creation also is Prajapati. That is the Prakaranartha. And in order to extol that, praise that. Avidvan Matantara Nindopanyasaha. The presentation of Ninda or the criticism of Matantara, of the other Mata or other opinion of Avidvan, of the ignorant people. Says the footnote number 2, Avidvan Mataiti Tathacha Vartike. This is what the Vartikakara says. Avidvat Devata Bhiddhi Pratishedhaya Sampratamiti. Avidvat Devata Bhiddhi. That's how it is. Bhid means Bheda. Dhi means Buddhi or the perception, the notion. Avidvat Devata Bhiddhi. The notion on the part of the ignorant people that the devatas are many, that kind of notion, Pratishedhaya Sampratam. This now is Sampratam. What now begins is Pratishedhaya, for dismissal of the notion on the part of the ignorant people that devatas are many. So this is the purpose of this particular section. Avidusha Parasyam Ekasyam Evahi Devatayam Ya Bhedadihi Tan Nishedhaya Adhuna Tadyat Idam Ityadi Vakyam Pravrittam Idi Yojana. Parasyam Ekasyam Evahi Devatayam. In fact, Devata is one, that is the Supreme Deity. Ya Bhedadihi, that one Devata alone is looked upon as many Devatas, not recognizing that all these Devatas are expressions of the same Devata. Tan Nishedhaya, in order to dismiss or in order to condemn or discard that particular notion, Adhuna Tadyadidam Ityadi Vakyam Pravrittam, that this Vakya on the part of the Upanishad, Tadyadidam, Amumyaja, that Vakya is there in order to accomplish this purpose. Sri Anandagiri, Matandare Nindidevi Katam Prakaranatha Studobhavati Idyashankyaha. For when you criticize thus the opinion of the Karmakandis or the people who have the vision of duality, by condemning or criticizing their opinion, how do you say that there is stuti of the oneness? So Vashyakara said, Anya Ninda Anya Stute. Ninda of one is always for the stuti of the other, always. So we always, in our own mind, whether it is clear to us or not, but whenever we do ninda of somebody or something, it is always for the stuti of something else. In order that this level is only this much, we lower down somebody else in order something else, in order to make this better. So in order to make someone short, we lengthen our line, that's what we do, or something like that. So this is also a tendency of the human mind to look down upon something in order that I feel that I am high above, you know. So anyway, so ninda, whenever it is done, is generally for unknowingly or unknowingly for the stuti of the other. So this being the human mind, therefore the Vedas also apply that method of communicating. When I hear the ninda, then I say, hey, that means something is better than this. Whatever tatpari is not in ninda, tatpari is always in stuti. And tatpari also is not in stuti, tatpari is to create in him a value for that. And why is the value created? So that he will do. A person will perform an action like upasana or karma ritual only when there is a value for that. And the value is that only when that is really exalted. And that is how to create a value this arthavada is there. Bhashyakara explains now the Shruti. Tadyat idam ahuhu. Tada tatra karma prakarane kevala yagnikaha yaga kale yadidam vacha ahu amum agnim yaja amum indram yaja ityadi nama shastra stotra karmadi bhinnatvat bhinnameva ajnani devam ekaikam manyamana ahuhu ityabhiprayah tanna tatha vidyat yasmat etasyeva prajapateh सामिश्रुष्टिः देवभेदः सर्वः एषः एव प्रजापतिरेव प्राणः सर्वे देवाः That means tatra, meaning what? Karma prakarane. In now, in the context of karma or in the context of ritual, and it should properly be done in ritual. You cannot say that all devatas are one, stuff like that. Otherwise, who will you worship? So, it is only proper that a proper vyavastha or division is done where it is required. Where it is not required, it should not be done. Here is a context where it should not be done. There is a context where vyavastha is required. You can't mix up everything. That's all. Some people, you know, because everything is going to be one in the stomach. So here also they mix up everything. So why have we made so many items? So when there is a plate, place rice, the vegetable here, and the prasan there, and chutney there, and the people mix up, then the mother will say, don't mix up everything. And this fellow, sometimes people don't know how to eat, you know, and they are very clumsy about it, so they don't have proper, you know, very sensitive of the taste and things, and therefore, so then they have to be educated there also. So wait a minute, now first eat this, then this, then that. Apo ama usho am khaun tem khaun sarkhu chana vado. It's not sarkhu, you know. No petma bhegutna hai, petma pale bhegutna hai. But outside it is separate and it should be respected accordingly. Inside it is one, it should be respected accordingly. So you should know what to mix and what not to mix. That's okay. But just because ultimately it is all going to be in one place doesn't mean that right away you mix them. There is a place where they should mix and there is a place where they should not be mixed, you know. And so, there are big mixers, you know, in the process plant. That is where things are mixed. Until then, they are all coming from separate sources. Each one of them comes separately. Each one of them is treated separately. When they become compatible, then alone they are mixed. Otherwise, you don't mix them. Mixing takes place when compatibility is first created. Otherwise, there is all kinds of problems. If you mix outside, where they should not be mixed. So first create compatibility, raise this thing to this temperature, that, etc., etc. When that is done, then you mix them in a proper proportion, then it's fine. So first you create compatibility by masticating and everything else, and then you mix them in the stomach, is all right. Anyway, so of course when you eat bhajiya, when you eat other things, so different kind of juices are secreted from the mouth and they are, you know, masticated, and then that is how masticated food goes in there. And then it is mixed. You don't mix them right away, you know. So because when you chew the food, there is a contribution from you also, that the saliva, the secretion is there, and all of that mix is there, and that is how. Then alone the food will be really digested and enjoyed. So if there is no appetite, therefore you just it just becomes a mill, you know, to actually just grind something. It's not merely a grinding mill, but then there is a faculty of taste, all things are involved in there, you know. Anyway, I don't know. But so in Karma Kanda, the idea is when this kind of distinctions are made, it is quite proper. So when and in Jnana Kanda that they should not be there, that also is proper. So when the mind said has a certain disposition, that is proper, that the vyavastha is there. Do this, don't say that, okay, do it, and then you leave everything, you know, in general. Then there is a lot of confusion there, naturally. Ultimately everything is going to be one, no doubt, but then all vyavastha, you know, everything is divided separately, naturally, because then all people will think and then they will organize accordingly. And later on it will all be one, you will not know who did what. But in the beginning, it's all separate there. So where division is required. And where, of course, a time comes, you know, where the division is not there, you know, so that is where it is not there. So all duality leads to unity. Idea is that there is a vyavastha in the duality. In order to recognize unity in the duality or diversity, it is necessary to organize diversity first, then alone you can see the unity, otherwise you cannot. If the diversity is all, you know, is haphazard, you can't see the unity. Therefore you take the material in certain way and organize, then make a house, then you call it one house, where so many components are united to become one. So when the diversity also is organized in a certain way, therefore the organizational mind, karma yoga and everything else, you know, to be able to organize our mind, to be able to at least appreciate diversity in a certain way. So when the diversity is organized in a certain way, then alone you can appreciate unity. You can't appreciate unity when there is a heap of parts lying there, you can't call it car. Only when they are assembled in a certain way that you can see a certain harmony that obtains in all of them, you know. So it is not possible to see the unity in diversity unless diversity is organized, or unless our mind is organized to see that organization that is obtaining. That's why there is so much difficulty we have in seeing the unity in the diversity, because it requires to organize that in a certain way. That's called yoga in that sense. But Bhashyakara said that tatra karma prakarane kevala yagnikaha. Kevala yagnikaha, yagnikaha means those people who are adept in yajna, they are called yagnikaha. But kevala yagnikaha, those people who are merely confined to the performance of yajna and nothing more than that. Or those people who take the yajna as the only end and not that yajna also the means for something higher. Those people who think that performance of the yajna is the ultimate thing, so kevala yagnikaha, those who are devoted to performance of yajna, or those who look upon yajna as the ultimate means, those people. Yaga kale, at the time of yaga, yadidam vachah ahuhu, when they make this statement, what? Amum yaja, amum yaja, amum agnim yaja, may you worship this agni, may you worship amum indram yaja, may you worship indra. Why do they say that? They believe that agni is different from indra, and naturally that is a reason for them to believe also. Bhashyakara says, there is no doubt a certain difference or separation or certain, you know, distinction between Indra and Agni. There is something that distinguishes Indra from Agni. What is it? Bhashyakara himself says, Nama, Shastra, Stotra, Karmadi, Bhinnatvat. What is Nama? Ekaikam Devamitasya Tatparimaha. Nama is what? Kathakam, Kalapakam, itivat nama bheda. So nama bheda is there, shastra bheda, stotra bheda, karma bheda. So the way you see, the name of Indra is Indra, name of Agni is Agni. The stotra, the hymns for praising Agni are different from the hymns of praising Indra. Shastra, other passages which also reside in praising Indra and Agni, they are also different. Karma, the manner in which you perform the ritual for propitiating Agni is different from what you do for propitiating Indra. The kind of materials you offer to Agni are different from those you offer to Indra, and therefore that karma also is different. So since all these differences are there in the Vedas, therefore they believe that Indra and Agni are really different in its essence also. This is the idea. that no doubt Indra and Agni are different from each other in many respects, but that as far as the essence is concerned, that they are one, that also they do not recognize. This is the idea. So, Nama, says Putnadama, Nama Indradi, Indra, Agni, these names are different of the Devatas. Shastra Stotra Stuti Visheshav. Stotra is a hymn that is sung, and Shastra is a hymn that is recited, you know, chanted. So certain hymns, stotras are to be sung. Like Dakshinamurti Stotra, Vedic stotras also to be sung, as in the Samaveda. So those stotras or hymns of the Rig Veda, which are sung as according to Sama, they are called stotra. And the very same stotras or the hymns of Rig Veda, which are not sung, but which are recited, they are called Shastra. Shastra and Stotra are Stuti Vishesha. They are different kinds of hymns, you know, Stuti. Tesham Pratidevam Bhinnatva Devaveda Ityartha. All of these being different from different Devatas, therefore, these Yajnikas believe that the Devatas are really different. Or says Anandagiri, Kathakam, Kalapakam, Itivad. Kathakam is what? So, footnote number 2. Kathaprauktam karma. In Vedas there are different shakhas. Kathaka, shakha. So, therefore the karma stated there. Kalapa shakha. And these karma stated are Kalapakam, Itivad, Namavedad. All these different names are also different of the shakhas. Kratushu tattat devata stuti bhedad. When you perform the yaga, the stuti of the hymns of Indra are different, the hymns of Agni are different. Ghata shakata devata atakriya bhedacha. And also the function that Indra performs is different from the function that Agni performs. So you propitiate Indra for attainment of certain end, you propitiate Agni for attainment of some other end. So therefore the priest will tell you to perform the upasana of Hanumanji versus Shani Devata, perform upasana of Lord Shiva. Different upasanas are being stated for accomplishing different ends. Therefore, artha kriya karyatvam, the function, the purpose that they serve are also different. Pratyekam devanam bhinnatvat karminam etad vachanam. From all the standpoints, since the devatas are all different from one another, therefore the karmis believe that the devatas are different, therefore they say amumyaja, amumyaja, naturally. Worship this devata for this result, worship that devata for that result, worship this devata in this manner, worship that devata in that manner. So manner is different, result is different, everything is different. And has to be. Like doctor saying, you know, take this medicine and that medicine. Because the diseases are different, naturally worships are also different. Adi shabdena rupa adi veda. Rupa is what? Vajrahastatvadi. So the form of Agni is different, the form of Indra is different, the description is also different. All these differences are there. Their vahan, vehicles are different, everything is different. So Vashyakara says, Tanna vittatha vidyat. Tanna tatha vidyat. May you not now take it that way, even though they say that all the devatas are different, and they enjoy the different upasanas for worship for them, don't take them to be different that way. See, Anandi, Nanvatra Karminam Ninda Na Prativadi. Ninda Cha Prativadi, no, Ninda Na Prativadi. Tan Matopanyasa Seva Pratidehe. It looks to us as though the Shruti is describing the Abhipraya of the Karmakandis and not doing the Ninda. Tan Matopanyasa Seva Pratidehe. It looks to us as though Shruti is presenting their Mata, rather than they are doing the ninda. Iti ashankyaha tanna iti. So Vashyakara says tanna tatha vidyat. Tanna means tad devata vedam tatha karvat na vidyat mumukshuhu. The mumukshu should not take the devata veda as ultimate veda, as the karmis take it to be. Why is it so? Because the reason is given. Yasmat etasyeva prajapatehe Savasrushti. Hetu is given because etasyeva prajapatehe savasrushtihi. The whole creation is the projection of Prajapati. Deva Bhedaha Sarvaha, all these devatas are creation of Prajapati. Eshu Eva Prajapati Eva Pranaha Sarva Devaha. This Devata Prajapati, meaning the Prana of the Hiranyagarbha alone, is all these devatas. Therefore, Mumukshu should not accept the duality of the devatas as believed by, should not accept as final the duality of the devatas as a karma is believed. It's one thing to take them to be, accept them as different for the time being. It's another thing to believe that they are ultimately different, and that kind of difference should not be accepted by Mumukshu. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti 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 Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Badarayanam Sutra Bhashya Krutau Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punaha Ishvaro Guru Ratmedi Murti Bheda Vibhagine Vyoma Vatvyapta Dehaya Dakshina Murtaye Namaha Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Hari Om. We read the mantra 6 on the page 173. Athetyabhyamanthata Samukhacha yoner hastabhyancha Agnima sujata Tasma detam uhayam alomakam Antartaha Alomakahi yonir antartaha Tadyajidamahuhu Amamyaja Amamyaja Ityekaikam devam Etyasseva savisrishtihi Eshaukheva sarve devaha Ahyatkincedamardram Tadredaso sujata Tadusomaha Etavadva idam sarvam Annam chaivannadascha Somevannam Agnirannadaha Saisha Brahmano Tisrishtihi Yat Shreyaso Devana Srijata Asayan Martyasan Amrutana Srijata Tasmada Tisrishtihi Atisrishtiyam Hai Asya Etasyam Bhavade Yajivam Veda. So he said that Prajapati, having churned by his hands in his mouth, he created fire, meaning that he created fire from his mouth. So mouth is the source of fire. So this is the creation of fire shown here. And so subsequently it says, Etasyevasa visrishtihi Eshavuhyeva sarve devaha. This is indeed the creation of Prajapati, and Prajapati indeed is all these devatas. This statement leads Vashyakara to say that the creation of fire also should be understood as creation of other devatas in order to complete the srishti. That Adhyatmika creation or Anugrahya creation was described in the earlier mantra. So Adhidaivika creation or Anugrahaka creation is to be described in this mantra. Then alone the srishti can be complete. So Vashyakara also said that we should understand that Prajapati also created Indra and Varuna and the devatas, which are the devatas of strength, and they are created from the arms. And Kshatriyas are also created from the arms. So Indra, Varuna, etc., the presiding deity of Kshatriyas, or Anugrahak of the Kshatriyas. Just as fire is Anugrahak of Brahmana, because Brahmanas are also said to have been created from mouth. Then Vasud and other Devatas were created from the thigh, the presiding deities of the Jati Vaishya. And the Pushan Devata was created from the feet, the presiding deity for Shudra. Thus these Devatas also should be understood to be created, because then alone the statement Esha Uyeva Sarve Devaha, that Prajapati indeed is all the Devatas, that statement would be appropriate only when we understand the creation of other Devatas. So in the last line of page 175, Vashyakara says, Tatra Kshatrāya Devata Sargam Iha Anuttam. So even though the Devatas of Kshatriya, etc., namely Indra and others, Devata Sargam Iha Anuttam, in this Kandika, the creation of Indra and other Devatas is not specifically stated. Vakshamānamapi. And it will be stated subsequently in other mantras from 11 to 13. Uktvat upasamharati. Upanishad concludes, does the upasamhara as though the creation of other devatas has already been stated. Srishti sakalyanu kirtyai. In order for the srishti sakalyanu kirtyai. So, srishti sakalyena anuktyai. In order to say that the whole srishti has been created. Srishti Paripurdi Kathanaya. In order to complete the Srishti Kathanam, it is to understood that these other devatas are also created. Yatha Iyam Shruti Vyavastita Tatha Prajapadireva Sarve Devaheti Nishchida Artha. As the meaning is well ascertained from this Shruti, it is very clear that Prajapati is all the devatas. Iti Nishchida Artha. That is the ascertained meaning. Srashtuhu ananyatvat srashtanam. Because those who are created are not separate from the creator, in as much as creator is both the nimitta and the upadana karanam. Prajapatina evatu srashtatvat devatanam. Oh, we have done all that. Then, further we already said, then tatra prakarane kevalayagnikaha yadidam Vachah Aho Amum Yaja Amum Yaja. Then next statement is taken up. That these Yagnikas say that worship this Devata, worship that other Devata. Ityadi Devam Ekaikam Manyamanaha Aho Iti Abhiprayah. That this Karmakanda is meaning the people who are totally devoted to Karmakanda. So those people who do not know anything beyond that, those who take the karma kanda or the karma as the ultimate patatpari of the Vedas, they believe that these devatas are all different from one another, because apparently there is a difference between them at the level of upadhi. Nama, the names of devatas are different. Indra, Varuna, Agni, and even then Shastra, Stotra, the hymns of them which are recited are different. So hymns for Agni and Indra, all devatas are different. And also the eulogical passages for them, shastras, are also different. The shakas in which they are described, sometimes they are also different. In this karma, the manner in which a certain karma is to perform, that also is different. So it seems that all these things associated with these devatas are all different. And therefore, naturally it leads one to believe that the devatas are also different. The hands appear to be different from the legs, the legs appear to be different from the head, and so each one has a different name, each one performs a different function, each one has a different place. Naturally one would believe that hands are different from legs and legs are different from head. Except that one should understand that even though all of these are different functionally at the level of upadhi, still they are one alone, that atma of all of them is one. If this is not understood, then the truth of the hands and legs and limbs is not quite understood. In which case, the way we would deal with them would not be proper. And this topic will be dealt with in this Upanishad again. You know, so again. As to when we worship God, who do we worship? Some will worship the heavens as God and some will worship Surya as God and so forth, meaning they are worshipping only one limb as a whole person, which is not right. So all the devatas are comparable to different limbs of the Virat Purusha, and to take them to be total is not right. And therefore, tanna adaraniyam, this opinion of this karmakandis should not be really accepted by the mumukshus. Tanna thavidyat, the way the karmakandis or the yagnikas believe that the devatas are all single and different, mumukshu tanna vidyat, that mumukshu should not accept that, inasmuch as that will not lead to moksha. That kind of an acceptance also is all right, as long as all you are concerned about is to get certain results by worship of those devatas, it is quite okay. So to take the devatas as different from one another does not create any problem, as long as all you are doing is to worship them and to seek certain limited ends. But if you want moksha or a total freedom or liberation, then it is necessary that one should know the unity that lies behind them. Therefore, mumukshu should not accept this opinion. See, Anandagiri, ekasyeva pranasya anekvidho devata prabedha shakalya brahmane vakshadevi vakshita vishinasti. How in shakalya brahmana, same devata, ekasyeva pranasya, prana means Hiranyagarbha. How Hiranyagarbha is one? Anekvidha devata prabedha. The same Hiranyagarbha is, appears or manifests as so many devatas. Shakalya Brahmane Vakshade. That is again, Shakalya Brahmane is in Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, 3rd Adhyaya, 399. That is called, so every Brahmana has a name here. That is called Shakalya Brahmana. Iti Vivakshitva Vishnasti. There it says, Katama Eko Devahaiti. So that was the dialogue between Shakalya and Yajnavalkya again, where this question is asked by Shakalya, Katama Ekaha Devaha Iti. Of all these devatas, who is the one devata? Pranaha Iti Uktva. Sahuvacha Mahimana Evaisham Ete Iti. That all these devatas are nothing but the Mahima, the glory of this Prana. Iti Ekasyeva Devasya Mahima Anya Devaha Iti Arthaha. That all these devatas, Indra, Varuna, etc. are all the Mahima or the glory of this one devata who is Hiranyagarbha or Saguna Brahma. Indra Mitram Varuna Magnim Ahuhu Atho Divyasya Suparano Garatman Ekam Sad Vipra Bahuda Avadanti Agnim Yamam Matarishvanam Ahuhu Iti. So Rukveda says this, Indram Mitram Varuna Magnim Ahuhu, they call this Hiranyagarbha or Ishvara as Agni. Indra, Mitra, Mitra means Surya, Varuna, Agni, all of these same devata is called by these names. Divyasya Suparana Garutman, or that Garuda, you know, is Suparana, and Divya, the divine, that also is nothing but the same Ishvara. Ekam Sat Vipraha Bahudha Vadanti. That Sat or Truth which is one, the wise call it differently. Well, how do they call it? Agnim Yamam Matarishvanamahu. That someone call him Agni, someone call him Yama, someone call him Matarishva. And all of these are the different names of same deity. Thus, this is a theme. In the Rigveda also, the last statement is from Rigveda. Earlier one is from Shakalya Brahmana, from Brihadaranyaka. How, even though in the Vedas, the devatas are individually glorified, there is no doubt about that. There are so many suktas, perhaps maximum number of suktas for Indra, and then for Agni, and for Varuna, and for Surya, for Prithvi, for all these devatas, many beautiful hymns are there, and all of them are praised. That means all of them have that individuality in a certain way, not that duality is non-existent, it does exist. But whereas that duality should be respected, it should also be understood that behind the duality there is the non-dual or the unity. So that also should not be lost sight of. And ultimately this duality should resolve into the non-dual. This is what the Vedas always show. Then Vashyagara said, page 178, Yasmat, Etasseva Prajapatehe Savasrushtihi Devabhedaha Sarvaha Eshaugyeva Prajapatereva Pranaha Sarve Devaha. Yasmat, Etasseva Prajapatehe Savasrushtihi. Since this is a creation or projection of this Prajapati indeed, Visrushtis, Devabhedaha, all these different Devatas are a projection or creation of one Prajapati. Esha huyeva prajapati reva prana. The Vashtakara uses the word prana, keeping in mind that Shakalya Brahmana, where it will be said that prana alone, the devatas are the glories of this prana alone. So it is said in Shakalya Brahmana, keeping that in mind, Vashtakara uses the word prana here. So this prajapati reva prana. Why is the word prana used here? So Anandagiri points out that Shakalya Brahmana vakshate. Since in Shakalya Brahmana that unity is going to be stated specifically, therefore to keep, bring that to our attention or indicate that to us, Vashyakara also uses the word prana here, prana sarve devaha. Now going back to the previous page, page 176, Mahashyakara said, that means tatra prakarane kevala yagnikaha yagakale yadidam vachaha ahuhu. The Vartikara has a long commentary upon this. And it's beautiful commentary. That this best passage, yadidam ahuhu amum yaja iti. So iti ekaikam devam. That the Yajnikas say that each devata is different, that may you worship Agni, may you worship Indra. And thus they take Agni, Indra, Mitra, Varuna, all these devatas as different from one another. Tan mumukshu, mumukshuna, tanna adaraniyam, that mumukshu should not accept that as the ultimate. And that this is a ninda. Ninda of duality in order to praise the non-duality. This is the thing that is done again and again in different ways. So this topic is taken up by Vartikakara for discussion as to how this passage is to be understood as ninda of the duality. Otherwise, amum yaja, somebody may think that is what this Upanishad says. May you worship this devata, may you worship that devata. See, no, Upanishad doesn't say that. Upanishad only reiterates that in order to criticize that opinion. Whose criticism is it? Is the criticism of the karmakandis or the wise people? Because here is the context of the jnana. So in the context of the Brahma Vidya, how can there be the tika or ninda of karmakanda or the karmakandis rather? So this looks like a ninda of the Brahma Vidya. All looks like ninda of the Brahma jnanis. And so this is not so. That's what the Vartikakara says here. So says the footnote, what they call Krodapatra. At the bottom. Kevala yajnikaha iti shuddha karmina iti avata. That this means shuddha karmina, meaning purely those who are devoted to karma. Tathacha vartikacharyaha ahuhu. Yadidam karmina prahuhu karmahumava medasaha avmagnimamum somam yajeti yaji samsrayat yajeti lingānindesha karmināmeva gammyate nadu vidvasta mohānām pratyaṃ mātrekashāyinām. Says yajnam karminah prahuhu. This karminah or kevala yajnikāha prahuhu, when they say karmahumo, where do they say this? This is amum yaja. Amum yaja is said in karmahumi, meaning it is said in the context of karma. This statement is not in the context of Brahma Vidya. This statement occurs, or similar statements occur where? In the karmakanda, karma bhumi. Amedasaha. People who do not have medha, people who do not have the intelligence to see beyond what is perceptible. Those who cannot read in between the lines. So the lines appear and apparently say that all the devatas are different. But when the spirit is not understood, that is called amedasaha. See, in the fifth line, the comments are also there. देवता स्वरूपधि वैधुर्यम एव अमेधस्त्वम्। देवता स्वरूपधि वैधुर्यम, नॉट नोइंग द स्वरूप ऑफ द देवता, सो बीइंग डिवाइड ऑफ द नॉलेज ऑफ द स्वरूप ऑफ देवता इज कॉल्ड अमेधस्त्वम, मीनिंग नॉट पजेस्ड ऑफ विवेक। सो दिस पीपल अमेधस कर्म भूमौ यद इदम प्राहुः, व्हेन दे से इन कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ कर्म अमुम अग्निम यज अमुम सोम यजेति, मे वर्शिप दिस अग्नि मे वर्शिप सोम इति यदि संश्रया, ऑन अकाउंट ऑफ द एसोसिएशन विद यज्ञ देयरफॉर वी से दैट यजेति लिंगात निंदायेश कर्मिणामेव गम्यते। सेज दि टीका, ननु आहुः इति क्रियापदं कर्तृमात्रम् अपेक्षते तद्विद्या प्रकरणत्वात् विदुषामेव तत्र कर्तृत्वम्। यदिदम् आहुः अमुम् यज अमुम् यज, हू सेज दिस? सी इफ यू लुक एट द उपनिषद स्टेटमेंट, तद्यदिदम् आहुः अमुम् यज अमुम् यज, तद्यदिदम् आहुः अमुम् यज अमुम् यज इति, दैट दिस पीपल से वर्शिप दिस देवता वर्शिप दैट देवता, who are the people who say that? So Vashyakara said kevale yagnikaha. Now that is Vashyakara's statement. Upanishad says that these people say that worship this devata, worship this devata. Ekaikam devam. So with reference to individual devatas, when it says that etasya etasyeva sa visrushtihi, apparently कर्तृ मात्र अपेक्षते यदिदम आहुः, देन दिस पीपल से, सो सम पीपल से दैट कर्तृ मात्र अपेक्षते, एंड सम पीपल से दैट ओके तद् विद्या प्रकरणत्वात् विदुषामेव तत्र कर्तृत्वम्। सो दिस सिंस दिस इज द प्रकरण ऑफ ब्रह्म विद्या, वी वुड से दैट ब्रह्म ज्ञानी से दैट अमुम यज, बिकॉज इट इज नॉट क्लियरली स्टेटेड हू स्टेटमेंट इज दिस, and therefore in the context of Brahma Vidya where we are, you would imagine that this also is a statement of the Brahma Jnanis. Na karmina amiri, all of a sudden how can Upanishad present the statement of karma kandis in the context of Brahma Vidya? Therefore na, that is not so. Yaji samshaya, said yaji samshaya, yajna means sacrifice etc. Therefore amum yaja, see that yaja and yaja, so that statement pertains to yajna, that statement does not pertain to Brahma Vidya. What is the statement? Amum yaja, amum yaja. And so this is a statement with reference to yajna and not with reference to Brahma Vidya. Yajeti lingat amum yaja, amum yaja, that yaja means may you worship, that yaja becomes linga or the evidence. Shruti does not clearly say, therefore we should go for the other evidence, namely linga. Therefore, this is a statement of the karmi and this is not the statement of the brahmajnani. If this is a statement of karmi, then it should be what? So, Tika says, Nanu asmin vakye devata bheda anuvada matram gamyade na karminindha. Alright. Because of the linga, namely yaja, suppose you say that this is a statement of the karmakanda, it's fine. That's one thing settled. But then how do you say this is ninda? That this is the truth that they are saying, you know, why do you say it is ninda? Nanu asmin vakye devata veda anuvada matram gamyade yadidam ahu amum yaja iti. So here it seems that Upanishad is concurring that all these different devatas are there. So devata veda anuvada matram gamyade, it looks as though this statement of Upanishad is anuvada or reiteration of the fact that the devatas are different. Na karmi ninda, why do you say that the statement is ninda or criticism of karmi or the performance of karma, performance of karma? Na chate ninditum shakyante, you cannot criticize or condemn the karma kandis because they are excellent people. Shreyo marge pravrtatva, if you say that Brahma, the vivid, so the mumukshus are are on the path of Shreyas, we say that those who are devoted to karma are also on the path of Shreyas. Yatha ahu, because that is what the Acharya say. Yo yagam anutishthati tam dharmikam idhi samachakshare idhi. That's what the Shabara Swami says. So in the commentary of the Pura Mimamsa, the Bhashyakara Shabara Swami says, Yo yagam anutishthati tam dharmikam idhi samachakshare idhi. The one who performs yaga is called dharmika. So in the Veda, dharma means yaga, primarily. So when these people are performing the yaga, that means that they are adharmika, meaning that they are devoted to dharma marga, and so dharma is nothing but the shreya marga. So those people who are on the path of shreyas, how can they be subject to criticism? Because what they are doing is for the welfare. And if the karmakandis who are on the shreya marga, if you can criticize them, then the Brahma, the Mumukshus who are the Shreya Marga also should be criticized. Because Karmis are also on the Shreya Marga, and then the Brahma Jnana, so Mumukshus, Vividushus are also on the Shreya Marga. Anyatha Vidushama Pi Nindasya. Then you will have to accept that if these Karma Kandis are criticized, then these Mumukshus also should be criticized. Or the even wise man also should be criticized. Tanna ayam puru paksha. Therefore, this amum yaja is not the paksha of the karmakandis, it is the paksha of the brahmajnanis. And therefore, this should not be also the ninda of the karmakandis. Let us say that the wise people say that they agree with the karmakandis in saying that amum yaja. We should understand this as a statement of wise people who reiterate the karmakandi statement that may you worship this devata, and you should not take the statement as the ninda of the karmakandi. Therefore it is said, yaja iti lingat ninda esha karminameva gamyate. Yaja iti lingat, because this linga, this is a ninda, karminam esha ninda iti gamyate, that this is the ninda of the karmis, not of karma, but of the karmis, not of the karmis also, of the aviveka, that's all. Yamimam pushpidam vacham pravadanti vipaschitah vedavadartah partha nandasti divadinah. In Bhagavad Gita also Lord Krishna seems to criticize. Lord Krishna criticizes whom? Karma? No, should not criticize Vedic karma. Criticizing the karma kandis should not be criticized. That also because Vedas are there, they enjoy the karma, and so they should perform. Yamimam pushpidam vacham pravadanti achetasaha. It is only the alpamedasaha or the avivekinaha. So not the people who are performing karma are subject to criticism, but people who take that is the ultimate. Or the Arthavada, where there is a praise of the phala, etc., that is taken to be the tatpariya of the Vedas, meaning those who are not understood the tatpariya, those who do not have that viveka, that aviveka is always criticized, not a person or not a thing at all. Nobody can criticize a person, nobody can criticize Shastra, otherwise Shastra would not be there. So Karmakanda also is very proper in the context in which it is stated. Karmakandis are also very proper in the context in which they are doing it. Except that a time should come when one has to grow out of it, and when one doesn't grow, then you ridicule him. This fellow was using his crutches, you know, because he had a fractured leg, but now keeps on using crutches even though he can walk. Then you will say, this is, you know, that means the fellow does not know the use of a crutch. Then the crutch is something that is to be given up at some point in time when one does not understand, then you may have to perhaps criticize him. So in order to release him from this holding on to the crutch. So that is how it is ninda always aviveka and not of anything else. Says the Tika, yadyabhi karmina karmani shreva marge pravrtan yohi purushan nishreya sena sanyunakti sa dharmaha tathapi तेषां एषा निंदा एव भेद अनुवाद व्याजेन सूच्यते अमुम यज्ञम यज अमुम इंद्रम यज इति वदन्तः देवतां निंदानः ते दृश्यन्ते. तथा च यम यथा संतमात्मानम इत्यादि न्यायात् अन्यथा ज्ञानलिंगात् निंदा योग्यास्ते भवन्ति इत्यर्थः। यद्यपि कर्मणि श्रेयोमार्गे प्रवृत्तान, इट इज ट्रू दैट दोज पीपल हु आर डिवोटेड टू कर्म आर ऑन द पाथ ऑफ श्रेयस, डेफिनेटली गुड इज गोइंग टू हैपन टू देम, नो डाउट अबाउट दैट। Today those who are performing karma, tomorrow you'll find them pursuing Brahma Vidya, there is no doubt, because that's the path laid out. But when will that tomorrow come? That is the idea there. So then there is a statement, Yohi Purushan Nishreyasena Sanyunakti Sa Dharmaha. So what is the definition of dharma? Dharma is that Yaha Purushan Nishreyasena Sanyunakti, not Nishreyasena Sanyunakti, that Nishreyasena Sanyunakti, that which unites or joins the people with Nishreyasa should be called dharma. That's how dharma is defined. Sa dharma, that is called dharma. Yaha Purushan Nishreyasena Sanyunakti, Nishreyasena Saha. So one who connects the Purusha, the people, with Nishreyasa should be called dharma. And therefore, these people who are devoted to path of karma are on the path of dharma, and therefore they are on the path of Nishreyasa, is understood. Tathapi tesham eva ninda esha, even then this is to be understood as their ninda. Why? Bheda anuvada vyajena suchyate. This devata bheda anuvada vyajena, that they are actually in the pretext of the anuvada, in the pretext of restating the duality among the devatas. In fact, what is intended here is the ninda of those who take the duality as real. That's all. Karminam eva gammete natu no. So karma humau amedasah amum agnim amum somum yajayati yaji samshrayat. So amum agnim yajay अमुम इंद्रम यजयति वदन्तः देवतां भिन्नानाः ते दृश्यन्ते। दोस पीपल हु कीप ऑन सेइंग दैट वर्शिप दिस देवता, वर्शिप दैट देवता, दैट मींस दैट दे आर एक्चुअली डिवाइडिंग दिस देवता फ्रॉम द यू नो वन फ्रॉम द अदर, एंड द डिवीजन ऑफ द देवतास इज नॉट राइट। योन्यथा संदमात्मानम अन्यथा प्रतिबुद्यते किम तेन कृतं पापं शौरेणात्मा अपहारणा, इन अ फेमस स्टेटमेंट दैट one who takes the truth to be different from what it is, he is performing, he is actually committing a sin. So Atma is pure or complete, and to take that Atma to be incomplete, you know, that also is considered to be a sin. And similarly, when the devatas are all one, to take them to be really different is also aviveka. And it is aviveka that is always subject to ninda or criticism. Ninda yogyaste bhavanditya, therefore they are ninda yogya, meaning not to ridicule them. See, ninda also is done, not really to criticize them, but to make them see, you know, above and beyond what presently they are. You see, naturally they have a certain conviction, and out of that conviction they are doing something, which conviction was necessary and helpful to do what they did so far. If right away you say that truth is one and so forth, then you can never worship the devata. Theek abhi, how can I worship Shiva and then Rama and Krishna, sab ek hi hai. Therefore the kind of devotion that you had for them, perhaps that would go away, you know. Sab mithya hai, and so all this mithya business, you know, naturally destroys sometimes. Again, when mithyatva is not quite understood, then perhaps one gets disillusioned. I thought that this devata, Shiva, is ultimate devata, and Shiva also is the same as Rama and same as Krishna and same as this and whatever happens to people, I don't know. As for how the devotion goes is not at all clear to me. In fact, devotion should become more mature. That what I thought was Lord Shiva is nothing but Param Brahma, and therefore my devotion should become, you know. But then somehow something happens to people when they listen to Vedanta. Swami, I am no one now interested in worship. How come? So those people who are so devotedly worshipping the devatas, after listening to Vedanta for a few years, then they give up everything because we are not interested. Then what? Then either we should understand why we are worshipping at that time, or we should understand what is it that makes me disinterested. So this is something to be understood. Because generally it is thought that Vedanta means worship is not there, and people who study Vedanta, they all stop worship. And that's what people do. They go and deposit the devatas in Nadi, you know, that's what they do. That's what literally people do. So some problem somewhere, you know, problem in... So when you do not understand also the significance or the purport of what is being said, even if Ninda is done, what for that Ninda is done when that is not clear? That Ninda also may take in a wrong spirit and people may misunderstand things. So Ninda also is done in a given context for the stuti of something else, so that one can grow out of something and graduate into something else. Not that one discards something and hangs on to something else. That's not the point. It is always to grow out of one and to grow into something else. And therefore, the idea is that ultimately to enable them to see this truth, that even though the devatas are different, that is also a fact at a given point in time, that there is a superior fact or a superior truth, that there is something superior to these devatas also. In fact, why should there be even insistence of non-duality? If the person is happy with duality, why worry? You need not worry. But when you find that the person has gained whatever there is to be gained from that worship, then what? Then we have to make that person see that there is something higher or superior also. That is, worship alone becomes more mature, or through that worship he can actually get something even better. That's the idea, to slowly make him see, not to condemn what he is doing, but to make him see something superior to what he is doing, so that then now a path is open for him to grow into something better. That's the whole idea. Therefore, to the right person, the right thing should be said at the right time. If to the wrong person, wrong thing is said, then all kinds of confusions are created. And so, at least the scriptures are extremely particular about it. Therefore, when this is said, so much discussion it is brought about, because how come this is said? Why should all of a sudden Upanishad say, in the context of Brahma Vidya, why should you say? Yaridam ahuhu amumyaja amumyaja iti ekekasya devatam, you know. So why should you say that? Why is that Ninda done? To say that someday one has to grow out of that vision of duality into the vision of non-duality. And therefore, it is that the vision of duality, or that the Vedas have the tatpari and the duality, is that shows that tatpari and nirna is not proper. That means the Vedas tatpari is not understood, and that is what is being criticized. So then it was said that this karma kandida shreya margi, if you do their ninda, then that means it implies ninda of Brahma Jnani is also, they are also on shreya marga. So says the yattu vidusha vininda syaditi tatraha, to say that if you criticize, if this is a criticism of the karma kandis, this should also be a criticism of the Brahma Jnani, he says no. Yajeti lingat yajisam ninda esha karminam eva gamyate natu vidvasta mohanam. But this is not the ninda of those whose moha, vidvasta mohanam, meaning those who moha, the ignorance is destroyed, of those wise people, this is not the ninda. So, natu vidvasta mohanam ninda yogyata. Naturally, those people who do not, or natu vidvasta mohanam, yeah, karminam eva gamyate, natu vidvasta mohanam, this is not the ninda of vidvasta, because they are not ninda yogya. Mohadvam se hetumaha. How do you say that moha, the delusion is gone away? Pratyang matraika shayinam. Because they only see in and through all the devatas, only one pratyagatma alone. So not only they appreciate the duality of devatas that obtains with the karma kanda is appreciated, but they appreciate something more than that. Yav pashyati, sa pashyati. Samam sarveshu bhuteshu tishthandam parameshwaram. So all the dualities are seen, but one appreciates that Parameshwara in and through, he really sees. And therefore, pratyang matraika shayinam. Those people who see one pratyagatma in and through all of them, therefore we say that their moha, the delusion, is destroyed. And therefore, they see they have the right perception. Therefore, this cannot be their ninda. Then Tika continues, Nahi kaschit kshanamapi ityadi smritehe jnaninamapi karmitvat nindasyat. Are you trying to say that jnanis don't perform any karma at all? Nahi kaschit kshanamapi jat utishtadiya karmakrut. Bhagavad Gita says that no one can ever stay even for a moment without some activity or the other. Karyate hi avashah karma sarvah prakrita jair gunaihi. That everyone is impelled or propelled, you know, to, or compelled rather, to do something or the other by the prakriti. That's why in Bhagavad Gita, Bhashyakara there makes it a point to say that this is a verse that pertains to ignorant and not the wise man. There also it is said. Same point is brought here. That since Bhagavad Gita says that no one can ever remain inactive, that shows that wise men also cannot remain inactive. So wise men also will perform one or the other karma. And if this is ninda of the karmis, then it will become also ninda of the wise man, because he also performs some karma or the other. This is not the ninda of the karmi. This is ninda of what? Of the vision of duality. It's not a ninda of karmi. So jnaninamapi karmitvat ninda syat. Since jnanis also perform one karma or the other, so they also should be called karmis, and therefore this will amount to their ninda also. Iti ashankya tesham akarmitve bhagavad vakyameva pramana iti. To say that the wise people are not karmi, meaning wise people do not perform the karma, even though they appear to perform karma at the level of body, they don't perform karma from their own standpoint. And of course, nahi kaschit, I mean, what, nahi vakinchit karom iti, many, many statements are there in Gita. Here, other statement is there, yastva atma dareva syat, atma truptasya manavah. So, Vatikara is very fond of direct bodily quoting this. And so the Panchadashikara, they bodily quote these verses. And just fit in, they don't even say that somebody says that. Because the verses are so famous that they are just quoted bodily and they form part of the main text. Yastva atma dareva syat, atma truptasya manavah. Atmanyevati santushtah tasya karyam na vidyate. So one who is rati in the atma, one who is trupti in the atma, one is santosh in the atma, tasya karyam na vidyate. Nothing remains to be done for him, meaning he does not do anything. So here the Tikakara explains what is rati and trupti and santosha. Manasollasah ratihi. Rati is a joy that one gains by dwelling upon something that one likes. Ullasaha manasaha. One, the joy that one gains by dwelling upon something that one loves. Tat anantarbhavisukam truptihi. And so one is that you enjoy thinking about something that you like. That itself is an enjoyment. And then secondly, what? That you actually experience what you like. Then what comes is called trupti. So it is Priya, Moda and Pramoda. And therefore, Priya Vritti is thinking about the object that you love. Moda Vritti is getting the object that you love. And Pramoda is the experience of the object that you love. How the happiness rises in intensity. Priya, Moda and Pramoda. So when you think about an object, it is Manasa, Ullasa, it is called Rati. Tadanantarabhavisukam truptihi. And then after the rati, what happens is called trupti. Saiva prakrishta santushtihi. When the trupti also becomes, I guess, you know, prakrishta, becomes exalted, it's called santushtihi. Avantara bheda, doesn't matter what the bheda is. The idea is that the wise man gets all his joy of every degree from atma alone, you know. So anyway, tasya karyam na vidyate. Now say the Tika, Atha Atra Muktasya Karma Abhava Varnade Vidushaha Tadabhavastu Katham. Alright. Now you want to separate the Mukta and Vidusha, you know. So what Lord Krishna says is Tasya Karyana Vidyade. This is being said for a person who is free. Why do we say that? This is being said for a person who is wise. Atha Atra Muktasya Karma Abhava Varnade Vidushaha tadbhavastu katham. How do you say that? This is karma bhava is stated here for vidwan or wise man. Idi ashankya ukta vakya tatparimaha. What is tatpari of the Gita vakya?
So yes, tvat manati, the tatpari of that vakya, the Vartikara explains, Utpannekātmeyāthātmeya bhāsvadvijñāna bhāskara samtuṣṭā vidyā bahula tamasām karma ninnutim.
Okay. Or let him be there, you know. Let him sit there, maybe.
Utpannekātmeyāthātmeya bhāsvadvijñāna bhāskara. This vijñāna bhāskara, this bhāskara, the son of knowledge. And bhāsvadvijñāna bhāskara, this brilliant or shining son of the knowledge, utpanna aikatma yathatma bhasvat. So the vijnana, which is the son of the knowledge, is what? Utpanna yathatma. So aikatma yathatma. So the one in whom the yathatma, the true knowledge of the aikya has arisen, you know. So utpanna aikatma.
Samplushta vidya bahulatamasam.
So those people whose avidya, so samplushta vidya bahulatamasam, those people of whom the darkness of ignorance samplushta is burned or destroyed. So those of whom the darkness of ignorance is destroyed by the shining of the bright sun of the knowledge of non-duality. Karma nindudim. Ninduti again means denial, or there for them is stated in this verse, karma ninduti, meaning that there is karma mukti or freedom from karma of those whose darkness of ignorance is destroyed by the bright sun of knowledge of the nature of the oneness of the Atma. This is what Lord Krishna says in this verse. That is what the Vartikakara says. So Vartikakara explains the tatparya of that verse in this manner. Sarva karmadhikaranam nishedam pratyapipadada. One pakar is added there, pratyapipadada. Sarva karmadhikaranam nishedam pratyapipadada. That is how much the Lord Krishna is there. Is what? So pratipaditam. So one that is pratipaditam, what is ishtaha. So that which is desired to be expounded. What? Sarva karma adhikaranam nishedham. That for the wise man there is nisheda or denial of all the karma. He is no more an adhikari for any karma. And since not adhikari for any karma, therefore there is no karma for him. The idea is that the wise man no more remains competent to perform, meaning he is not an adhikari for any karma at all. He is not an adhikari for nishidha karma, nor is adhikari for kamya karma, because there is no kamana, nor is adhikar va nitya naimitya karma, because he doesn't have any identification with his upadhi. He does not entertain notions about his identification, and therefore he is not adhikari for any karma. And therefore, sarva karma adhikaranam nishedam pratyapipadada. Therefore, what Lord Krishna has expounded there or propounded is a denial or a freedom from all adhikaritvam for the wise man. Adhikarapadena pravrtyadi graha. So sarva pravrtti also. So that he is free from all pravrtti or karma. Then the tika continues, nacha bhagavadukte. So karma ninnutim pratyapipadada iti sambandha. So then there is a pratipadanam of karma ninnutim or denial of karma. And that is what is how that pratyapipadada goes with karma ninnutim and sarva karma adhikaram nishedam, both of them. That verb goes with karma ninnutim as well as nishedam. Nacha bhagavadukte vastuni avishvasaha. Yeah, but then Lord Krishna has said, okay, but how do you say that it is to be taken as pramanam? So you are quoting a statement from Smriti, and why do you take it as pramanam? Nahi bhagavadukte vastuni avishvasaha. Like, come avishvasa or distrust in what Bhagavan says. Adhikari lakshana vishishtaya pradipadatatva. Because this is stated by none other than Lord Krishna, and is stated to none other than Arjuna, who is adhikari lakshana vishishtaya. So one who has a lakshana of the adhikari, Arjuna, who is such, to whom this is stated, to him this is stated, and therefore we should not have avishwas or asraddha in this statement of Lord Krishna. Therefore it is said that Puranaha Shashvato Vishnu Prapannaya Kiridine, that Puranaha Shashvataha Vishnu Prapannaya Kiridine. So this is what is said by Lord Krishna. Kiridine Nishedam Pratyabhivadada. To Arjuna, kirita means one who is wearing the kirita or the crown. To this Arjuna, this is what Lord Krishna has said. Says, who is Lord Krishna also? Anadyanantaha vyapanashilascha bhagavani vaktum vaishishtimaha purana haiti. Purana means what? Anadi. And one who is shashvata means what? Ananta. Vishnu means what? Vyapanashilaha. So is anadi, nidhanaha, one who is devoid of adi, anta and all pervasive. That is what Lord Krishna is. Don't take him to be a person. So this Lord himself is in the form of Lord Krishna, saying this to Arjuna, who is an adhikari also. Therefore, what Lord Krishna has said is to be taken as pramana. And there it is said that the wise man is free from all the karma adhikaras and karma. And therefore, this cannot be ninda of the wise people. It has to be taken only as ninda of the karmi. And ninda of the karmi also is because those people see these devatas are different from one another. And therefore, that duality at the level of devatas is what is meant to be criticized here, in order to make them see that ultimate truth is the non-duality in and through the devatas. Now go to same page 177 in the Tika. The Tikagara continues the quotation of the Vartika. Because Yadidamahu Amumyaja Amumyaja iti, that statement is explained in all these Vartika shlokas. Then subsequently, see if you go to 12th, 13th line, तद्यदिदं इत्यादिना पूर्वपक्ष अनुवाद द्वारा कर्मिणां निंदा न विदुषाम इति उक्तम्. दैट व्हेन श्रुति सेज तद्यदिमाहुः अमुम्यजे अमुम्यजे इति इति इत्यादिना पूर्वपक्ष अनुवाद द्वारा, दैट इज अनुवाद और रीटरेशन ऑफ पूर्वपक्ष मीन्स द कर्मकांड पक्ष और कर्मी पक्ष राधर कर्मिणां निंदा. बाय दैट रीटरेशन इज मीन द निंदा ऑफ द कर्मी. Na vidushaam and not of the vidwan iti uktam. That was stated in so many shlokas. Idaim tanna, that is bhashya. Shruti doesn't say that, but bhashya says. That bhashya says on page 178, tanna tatha vidya. So mumukshu tatha tanna vidya. Mumukshu should not accept it as such. That bhashya is what now Vartikakara explains. Tanna ityadi bhashyam vyakurvanna nindaphalam nishedam darshayati. In order to explain what is the meaning of that statement, tanna of the bhashya, nindaphalam nishedam darshayati, that nindaphala, which is nisheda, is what the Vartikakara shows mithayati. So says the verse there, mitho bhindam yadahuste ekaikam deva madhvare tadasat pratipattavyam yato bhinnaiva devata. Alright, that the Shruti does the ninda of the karmi. What is the purpose of that ninda? What is the nisheda phalam? Ninda is done not for the sake of ninda, but it is said in order to convey something. What is it that the Shruti seeks to convey by the karmi ninda? That is what the Vartikakara explains. The Shruti seeks to say that actually there is only one devata, that the duality is not right. So it is said here that mitho bhinnam yadahuste ekaikam devam adhvare. When they adhvare, in the context of yajna, when they say that these devatas are all individual and separate from one another, so dasat pratipattavyam, that should be known to be asat or wrong.
यतः अभिन्ना एव देवता
बिकॉज देवता namely प्रजापति इज वन अलोन एंड देयरफॉर दिस देवताज आर नॉट डिफरेंट फ्रॉम वन अदर इन द अल्टीमेट एसेंस सेद टीका विश्वं भूतं भुवनं चित्रं बहुधा जातं जायमानं च यत् सर्वो शेष रुद्र इति श्रुतेः आत्मा एव देवता सर्वा इति श्रुतेः एकं वा संयोग रूप चोदनाख्या विशेषादिति न्यायाच्च आत्मत्वेन देवदैक्यादि हेतुमाह यतः इति यतः बिकॉज अभिन्ना एव देवता द देवता इज वन अलोन अभिन्ना From Shruti, Smruti and Yukti. Yukti means Nyaya. Nyaya can be either Puru Mimamsa or Uttara Mimamsa. So, says here, Vishwam, this comes from Shruti. Vishwam, Bhutam, Bhuvanam, Chitram, Bahudha, Jatam, Jayamanam, Jep. This whole creation, Bhutam which was there, Bhuvanam which is being there, Chitram which is all variegated, Bahudha jatam jayamanam cha, that which is born variously and that which is being born. Yat sarvo hyesha rudra. This is all rudra. So in the praise of rudra it is said, the rudra alone is the whole creation. So creation that was there and creation that was born, the creation that is coming up, creation which was in the past, creation which is in the present and the future, all of that is nothing but this rudra. This is what the Shruti says. That means Shruti says that Rudra or one Devata alone is his whole creation. You Agna, you Apsuyo, Oshadi, Shuyo, Vishyo, Rudra, so Agni, Oshadi, Yap, in all of them, this Rudra alone is appears as all of this. So Rudram says that.
Atma eva Devata sarvaha iti smrutehe.
So Atma eva sarvaha Devataha. All these Devatas are nothing but Atma alone, that's what the Smruti says.
Vishava that is ekam va then nyaya the puru mimamsa ekam va sanyoga rupa chodana akhya visheshadidhi jaimini sutra
that jaimini sutra is explained here in the next page see page 178 footnote number 2 same thing is restated there विश्वं भूतं भुवनं चित्रं बहुधा जातं जायमानं चेत् सर्वोशेष रुद्र इति श्रुतेः नंबर 1 आत्मैव देवताः सर्वाः इति श्रुतेः दैट इज श्रुति इज आत्मा अलोन इज ऑल द देवताः एकं वा संयोग रूप चोदनाख्या विशेषादिति न्यायात् च आत्मत्वेन देवता ऐक्यादिति हेतुमाहुः यस्मादिति सो देन द टीका सेज अत्र So, ekam va sanyoga rupa chodana akhya avisheshad. The context there is that when in different shakhas a karma such as agnihotra is enjoined by the Vedas, so agnihotra karma that is found in Rug Veda, Yajur Veda, in different places, in different shakhas, the agnihotra karma that is being enjoined by the Vedas, is it the same agnihotra karma or a different agnihotra karma? This was the question there. So there the Nyaya, the ultimate conclusion is that Agnihotra Karma is the same in all the Shakhas. Why is it so? Because Sanyoga. Sanyoga means Phalam. Then the Phala or the result of the Agnihotra Karma is stated to be same in all the branches. Rupa. Rupa means what? Iti Kartavyata. The manner in which the Agnihotra is to perform also is the same. Chodana meaning what? Purusha prayatna, the prayatna that is to be done by the person also is the same. Akhya, akhya means nama. That is Agnihotra, the name also is the same in all the branches. Etesham, so avisheshad, etesham, avisheshad, ekam abhinnam karma iti sutrataha. Therefore, since all of these are the same in all the shakhas, therefore we say that the Agnihotra or any other karma which is described in more than one shakhas, is one karma alone. So in that Nyaya, ekatma the karma is stated, but the same Nyaya, ekatma the devata also should be understood. That's the Nyaya. Okay, now going back to our discussion here. Yataha abhinna eva devata. Since devata prajapati is abhinna one alone. Then says Tika, आत्मनि अपि प्रतिदेहं भेदात् कथं तत् अभेदेन दैव देवतैक्यमिति आशंक्याः भेद इति शेष वाद्यकार भेदग्राही ननोमानं घटादावपि विद्यते वाद्यकार शेष as far as we are concerned even घटपट also there is no प्रमाण You don't have any valid means to prove that this pen is different from the microphone. As far as we are concerned, he says, Naha, for us, Bhedagrahi namanam ghatadavapi vidyate. For us, even in ghatapata. So, as far as we are concerned, we do not have pramanam even to prove that there is bheda or the distinction between ghata and pata. So Upadhi Veda is there, but the Tatvika Veda we don't accept even when Ghata Pata. We say that Ghata looks different from Pata is a limitation of eyes or limitation of mind and not because they are different. So what the Vedantins will ultimately say is that it is this mind that projects the duality on Ghata Pata, not that it is really there. So you cannot prove really the duality between Ghata and the Pata. As today's scientists also will say, That ghata, pata, matha, all of these are nothing but the manifestation of the same energy and therefore you don't have really mana or the pramana or the valid proof to show that they are different from one another. So right then Sureshwaracharya says, scientists may say today, but Sureshwaracharya says even then, Vedagrahi nanomanam ghata davapi vidyate. Even in ghata pata also that bheda is there, such pramana is not there as far as we are concerned. That just because you perceive the colors as different, the forms as different, is not to say that they are tattvika technically or in the truth they are different. Kyo nishesha bhinnata vyapini atmani asau mai? Then what to talk of the fact that there is no pramanam to see the duality in atma or who is asu meaning the prajapati, you know, so I am the prajapati, in that there is no duality, then what to say? If we do not see the duality even in Ghatapata, then what to talk of the duality in different devatas or nothing but Prajapati? Kyu nishesha bhinnartha vyapini atmani, the atma that pervades all the different bhedas or all the different nishesha bhinna, all those things which appear to be different, the atma that pervades all the different manifestations, In that Atma which is Asau, Asau means in Asau in the Prana, in Atma with the Prana, then there is no duality. What to talk of that when we do not see the duality even in Ghatapata? That's the thing. Says Tika, explaining that. Hiranyagarbhe Asau. Asau somebody may think means that, you know, but Asau here means the seventh case of the word Asu. Asu means Prana. Prana means Hiranyagarbha. So Tika explains Hiranyagarbhe Asau. प्राणस्यापि स्वरूपभूते सर्वप्रत्यगात्मनि भेदग्राहिमानं न इति किं वाच्यम् दैट वी डू नॉट फाइंड द भेदग्राहिमानं इन घटपट देन व्हाट टू टॉक ऑफ द फैक्ट दैट वी डू नॉट सी द भेदा इन हिरण्यगर्भ हु इज ऑल एनकंपसिंग और हु इज ऑल परवेजिंग एंड दैट देयर इज नो मानव प्रमाण इन द ड्युअलिटी ऑफ हिरण्यगर्भ और द डिविजन ऑफ हिरण्यगर्भ देन व्हाट टू टॉक ऑफ दैट Pranasyabhi swarubhu bhute. The Hiranyagarbha who is even the essence of prana. Or pratyekatma rather, pratyekatma who is the swarubha of even the Hiranyagarbha. Swarubhu bhute swarubh pratyekatmani. In the pratyekatma who is the essence even of the Hiranyagarbha. That there is no division in pratyekatma. What to talk of that? When there is, we do not see division even in Ghatapata, which are the grossest manifestation of Pratyekatma, when we don't see duality there, what to talk of seeing duality in Pratyekatma? Then there is no question at all. So we don't see the duality at all. You prove to us that this is different from that. You prove. We don't see any duality. You prove that Ghata is different from Pata. Just because you call it Ghata and you call it Pata, that is why it is different. Because ghata has a different use, pata has a different use, therefore you call it different. Since ghata is in one place, pata in another place, therefore you call them different. As far as we are concerned, this nama, rupa and karma, these are not the criteria to actually establish the duality. That's what the
कारिकाकार सेज दैट घटाकाश पटाकाश मठाकाश ऑल ऑफ द आकाश गेट्स ऑल दिस डिफरेंट नेम्स एंड दे सीम टू हैव डिफरेंट नेम्स दे सीम टू परफॉर्म डिफरेंट फंक्शंस एंड ऑल ऑफ देम दैट डजंट मेक देम डिवाइडेड And similarly also one Atma alone because the Upadhi appears as Ghata, appears as Pata, appears as Matha and therefore all the Vedas are only at the level of Upadhi, not in the essence. So we do not see any duality anywhere. So he says, for us there is no Pramanam to establish duality. Vyavahara is okay, but there is no Pramanam to establish the ultimate reality of the duality.
श्रुत्यंतर अवस्तंभेना भी देवता भेद अभावम साधयति
also by resorting to other shruti which looks like Mundaka Upanishad or elsewhere so by resorting to other shruti also we can see how there is no bheda between the different devatas so devata bheda abhavam sadhayati the vatikakara establishes the abhava the absence of the duality among the different devatas by taking the resort of other shruti.
Na bhaiti, na bhavaradi, that's right. Na bhavaradi vad vishvam adhyatmadi vibhagavada ota prudatmana tatsthau virat sutradi vastushu. Na bhav aradi vad.
Navi means an axle. Ara means the spokes. How all the axles are fixed to the spoke and how therefore the hub, not the hub but the rim is supported, what we call the wheel is supported by the spokes because all the spokes are actually attached to the navi or the axle or the hub. So how all the spokes are attached to the hub, how the spokes derive their existence or support from the hub. How the movement, the dynamism or the motion that the spokes have is also from the hub. So how that wheel gets its support and the motion and existence, everything from the hub, and so also the whole creation gets its motion and dynamism and existence from the hub, which is Atma.
So arai navo aradivat vishvam adhyatmadi vibhagavada.
This Vishwa, the creation which is generally divided as Adhyatma, Adhibhuta,